So we have come down in the last part, you know, and it's the part will get tickly, you know. Yeah, kind of tickly, the part are tickly. As we tell you, say, most of it, even them countries profess to be Christian countries. And most people go to church Sunday. I don't know why. But them go to church Sunday because them feel say they may find some kind of solace and peace from the whole week. The first day of the week, which most people don't really consider the first day of the week. Them feel say Monday are the first day of the week. But it's Sunday is the first day of the week. For your information, Sunday is the first day of the week. Saturday is the seventh day of the week. Now the seventh day them say it's Saturday them I work with. Roman Catholic and those who's influenced by Roman Catholic say it's Sunday them I work with. Because really and truly, there's a man named Constantine, this emperor of Rome, who, because the Romans them used to praise and give homage to the sun in the sky, and the Christians them used to give the sun what them call Jesus. Him decide say, instead of aggravate the two set of people them, he might merge the two things in a one. So him decide say, all right, to appease the people them who worship the sun in the sky and the people them who worship the sun, the Father, the Son, the Holy somebody, Jesus. What we're going to do is, all right, for the first day of the week, we're going to celebrate the two Sundays. So them call it the Sunday, the day of the sun, just like Monday is the day of the moon. But people don't know that. You know, them give names according to the celestial bodies in the sky and also them gods. Seen, and them emperors like Julius Caesar, it's July, and Augustus Caesar like August. And if you follow and go look up the information, you'll find, say, all of these things come from Greek and Roman thinking. So, in our country, our countries, them give a thing named Christianity. Most people, them change their political affiliation quicker than how they change their religion. And most people feel almost adamant about them religion more than them political affiliation. And most Christians not really want your question where them believe in. But yet still most Christians want put forward where them believe in, like it's knowledge. And belief is really not knowledge. Belief is what you call faith. You have a faith. And you can't really question a man's faith. But when the man uses his faith as a historical reference point, then you have to bring the evidence and show you, say, well, if you tell me, say, this is part of that, show me the evidence for it. Now, we have a thing named the Bible. And the Bible, most Christians will tell you, say, is God write the Bible, or God inspire men to write the Bible. And them say, you can't say nothing about it. And everything we're in it, I just sweat go. You can't use your intelligence, you can't use your brains to imagine or even contradict. I even come to a logical explanation and understanding about where the Christian really are say, when him say, where him say. So you're always in a tussle with a person who is adamantly religious. Religion is really a seriously a oppressive kind of system. Religion strives from fear. Religion was created by insecure men to oppress women. Yes. Most religion that I know oppress women. Them don't have a woman are a feminine energy that dissolve into the divinity of the God where they must search for. Especially in the Western world where the system is patriarchal. We do have a matriarchal system. Yet still, most indigenous people, whether you go to Australia amongst the Aboriginal people, whether you go in Africa, whether you go in America, where the indigenous Native American there, they have a balance between the male and the female. Them not just say E. It's a weird thing. Because every time you hear a one address something that is not gender related, him say E. Like if him say God, the first thing him says E. Yes, still God not supposed to have no gender, you know. But because of the patriarchal mindset that we find ourselves in this Western world. Anything that is great and bigger than we say E. Not recognizing, say, the indigenous people them used to say Mother Earth. And Mother Nature. There's a reason why them say Mother Earth and Mother Nature, you know, because it functions in the feminine. When we talk about feminine now, we're not talking about man will behave like woman. We are talking about energy. Energy that is not male or female, but there's a certain feminine energy. And feminine energy mean compassion. A certain sympathetic attitude that the masculine energy don't have. But when you look on a female, there's a certain compassion. You know, a woman have this compassion about her. That is why she get the hard work of bringing forth children. Because there's a certain compassion in that feminine energy that is necessary in the man. And we need to grab back that energy. We lose that energy somewhere between the Middle Passage and the fast food restaurant them. So in our African tradition now, we have this thing named male and female energy. And we give it up for the Christian energy. And the Christian energy tell us, say, is woman bring sin in the world? Yeah, there's a woman named Eve. It's a weird story. For those of you who go to church, I hope so. Well, one is not Eden inside. The church thing is really important because we grew up in it and we don't question it because them put a fear in our way, say, if you question it, you're sin. So, no care a man intelligent. From it reach him religion, him lose him intelligence. Him nobody think again independently. Him just follow where the things say, like zombie. No. There's a story where something where them says he made the earth in 7 days, 6 days, and rest on the seventh. Obviously, him get tired because it's really a big job, really. So, he make something named man. And it's the weirdest thing because he make the man and the man did it by himself. And this he wanted a gardener. Because he make a garden and no rain, he never make no rain. I don't know why he never remember say flowers want rain and food want rain. So he make the garden and he would obviously believe say the mist of the morning would water the garden, but it wasn't working. It's really strange for something he that is omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient never realize a plant was more than just mist. But make a work with the story. He put the man in the garden and say, all right, check out the garden and work with it. Only if you find out, say, one day when he walk, he realize it, and he was walking too, you know. Yeah, he walk. He walk. It said, go read it. Genesis 1 and 2. I don't want to sound like a preacher, I know even though it's Sunday, but what is to be done is to be done. But him look on the man one day and realize the man was lonely. Now, this is an omniscient, omnipresent, omnipotent something named E, which people call God. He never realized if he make this one man, the man would be lonely. But he make the man, and him said the man was lonely. So, he realized the man was lonely, and guess what he do? He call all of the animals them to the man. Now, I don't know why he call the animals them to the man. Trust me, that sound kind of strange to me. Really. I mean, why would you want to call the animals them to the man? But that is how the story go. It's not me I write the story now. Go read it. Genesis 1 and Genesis 2. So the man there, I play with the animal them, and I do a survey, I do with the animal them, and him name the animal them, all right, you name cow, you name ass, you name donkey, you name cow, you name dinosaur, you name all sorts of things, the man call all sorts of names. But him pass again, and him realize, but wait, the man still look lonely. The animal them not really work with him. I'm not work with the animal them properly. So, him say, boy, I'm going to put the man to sleep. Him put the man to sleep and take out her ribs out of the man. Really and truly. Really and truly. Woman is an afterthought, you know, according to the story, you know. Him never really intend to make woman, you know. I want the woman them know that, you know. We don't never really intend to be here, you know. You understand? That's why man treat woman so, you know. Because of that story. It was not the intention of God to put woman on earth. It's because him look upon the man and realize the animal them never suffice him. So he have to go find something that make him don't feel lonely. So he put the man to sleep and take out him ribs. And then him shape up some mud and, you know, get a pump and pump some ear in it. And it start to look a different way from the man. And him realize, well, the man, I work with that thing, you know. So him still have to call it man, you know, but him say, whoa, man. All right, now. So the two of them in this place, you know, are nice and thing, you know. According to them, you know, it's the two first people, you know. That's how me learn in a school, you know. I learn in a church, you know. And I hope you, I know, say, so you did learn that too, you know. So the man and the woman in the garden, them say, you name Adam, you name Eve. Him say, all right, now. This thing that is called God. Of a tree. It's weird because we always believe it was an apple tree. American apple tree at that. Yeah. Most of the women I think about the trees, American apple tree. Not even the green one them too, but the red one them. Really. We pay a red apple on it. And we have two white people sitting up on it with a snake wrapped around the apple tree, so attack. It's a strange story. Alright. So God put the tree. It never say apple, you know. It say the tree of knowledge of good of evil. So him put the tree over there, so and say, Adam, watch out now. You see, of all the tree them where you want to eat of it. But you see, that tree there, don't go eat on it. Adam say, all right, I no problem. I have enough fruits on there, so. I may have animals too, can work with. So we now work with that tree there. All right. One day, the woman walked by herself. And when she go near the tree, she say a snake wrapped around the tree. And now, you know, the story gets more ridiculous now because the snake attack. It couldn't be a black woman that. No black woman now stood up and talk to no snake. She had to run. What snake? I'm going to run. God. No black woman now talk to no snake. Me can't vote a black woman for that. Because I see my auntie run out of the bathroom already because she see a little lizard in the bathroom. Naked as she did, she was born. She run out and I say, Lord God, a snake. A lizard in the bathroom. The lizard not trouble at all. Miss woman run from roach. Much less a snake wrapped around a tree. Couldn't a black woman that trust her. Anyway. So the snake I got talk now. No, you want to know. You see this tree, it's because God knows, say, you're going to be like him, knowing good and evil. Why I'm telling you to eat it, you know. And the woman I say, it's not me, he tells you, it's Adam. He say, see this, so me I tell you, say, so you can't eat it. Yeah, man, you're going to be like God if you know. If them say, the serpents are deceived the woman, you know. But when you really read the story, you realize it's not a deception, you know. It's God don't want you to be like God, knowing good and evil. So he put this up. So, of the tree of good of knowledge of good and evil. So the snake I said, come on, eat the thing, man. And you'll be like God. So the woman said, all right, boom. And she bite the fruit and wow, tastes like it now no genetically modified thing in it. So it can't work. So she go to her husband and she said, well, you want to say, it's the tree where God said we know if you eat from. I tell you the fruit. It has a one. So the husband take the fruit. He says, I'm going to eat it. God walk up on him sneakingly. I say, oh, me tell you, say, of all the three them you must eat, but that one that you must eat of, hear him now, is the woman, man. It's the woman, son. You see, from God, you say, the woman, God has turned to the woman and said, look, you know, me have a curse, you know. In childbearing, you shall have pain. And the snake shall bruise your heel. And into generation to generation. And then him look for the man and say, you, by the sweat of your brow, you shall eat bread. Now, if me was Adam, really supposed to ask a question, what is bread? Because no bread never in them days there, really. So, the idea of the sweat of your brow, you eat bread. I want to say, but we never planned bread yet. I will name bread. I mean, the story kind of ridiculous still, but. Yeah, because a thousand of years after bread originated, invented, you know, appear animal and birds and flowers and trees and things there. So when God said, by the sweat of your brow, you should not eat bread. You wonder, wait, then old bread never invent them time and tell the man that. The man's supposed to get confused. But guess what? God chased them out of the yard now, you know, and put a sword, a flaming sword, and say, lest man take of this tree and become like one of us, knowing good and evil. Let us chase him out of the garden. This is what God said, you know, after him chase out the man and the woman. And him say, lest man become like one of us, knowing good and evil. Him going to chase him out of the garden and put a flaming sword in front of the entrance that him can't come back in there. So the man gone and the woman gone out there. So now, them realize they can't have sex. Cain born first son, Abel born second son. Now, some of you know, say, no, God don't like vegetarian. He don't like vegetarian. Because the story say, Cain is a farmer, and Abel is a hunter. And Abel take all of the animal them and offer it up as a sacrifice to the Lord. Because the Bible say, God loved the scent of dead flesh. So when God smelled it, he said, McDonald's, Kentucky, Burger King. Here now, him take all him fruits and him apple and him banana and lettuce and this and that, cut all some pear and all everything and put it down. And when him come back, they don't touch at all. So vex him, I get vexed, dog. And I say, wait. Oh, you kill off all of the animal then. And so cruel. And God love your things. And him not love my thing. So Cain just kill him, brother. Kill him, brother. Can't get jealous now. He must say, watch a man. After me tile so hard. And I work the ground and them things. I look how my fingernail them stay. I can't even put nothing on my fingernail. I can't go get no manicure. I can't even put nothing on my fingernail. I can't go get no manicure and pedicure and all them things. And God just deal with your things. So just kill him, brother. But yeah, the story get weird now. Because me got school, mathematics show me say, if Adam and Eve is the first two people upon earth, and Adam bring Cain and Abel, it's four people upon the earth, and Cain kill Abel, three people upon the earth. But the Bible say, Cain went to the east of the garden and found himself a wife. So me I say, wow. I wonder if Adam did that so something with the animal them that we never know around us, so that him go find himself a wife, Rasta. Maybe it's the tree monkey who set up on the coconut tree will evolve from them and come over there. So, but the story kind of get weird because really and truly, that's really, anybody ever hear about Anansi? Anansi is an Ashanti folk tale. It's about a spider who's tricking. Now, nobody really believes it. You have a spider in Africa we attack. That's a Ashanti folktale. So why is it that the snake in this garden is not a Jewish folktale? Because it's really a Jewish folktale. It's nothing else but a Jewish folktale. Because snake cannot talk. Snake cannot talk. The story is metaphorically written that you need to understand it on the next level. But these preachers and theologians who trick the people them every Sunday, them don't understand what is the metaphysical understanding of the story. It's like Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall, Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. Maybe the man never really talk about no egg. Maybe really talk about a system in a Europe. The egg is really the king. Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's arson and the soldier them couldn't put the system together again. We don't know. But maybe it's that him attack. No. I sure know, say, the people them who did a write a story there have sense. And them never intend if we believe, say, those things was physically happening. Them don't really be the one if we believe that. But these people come and make it history. So them have a faith and a belief. And the faith and the belief translate into historical things. So them tell you, say, no, it's a historical thing. Yes, God can do anything. He makes snake talk and donkey talk. Is there all that these kind of story in the Bible, you know? Donkey attack, snake attack, the sun a move and all them something there. And it gets strange. And a guy build a boat. 500 foot long, according to the book. The boat is 500 foot long. With one window. and one door. And him put a pier of every animal in that 500-foot boat for nearly a year. And all of these animals in there, where the hell them shit go? When them pack up the shit and put it, where them pack it up? Where the elephant has stand up on the rabbit? And the animal them who eat animal, I eat the other animal them. And the giraffe in them neck of your turtle, so because the tone, and the window no open, no air condition, no in there. And the 8 people them with all of these animals in. Oh, him get all of 2 pair. Oh, him get a pair of every animal in there. And him set up at the door. Okay, Japheth, coming in, 2 cows. Look at them if they say, him say, okay, yes, sir, father, animal, yes, male and female, you can go. Okay, 2 mosquito. What? Oh. Daddy, I can't tell the difference here, though. You have to come and help me here. Son, you need a magnifying glass, man. But them don't invent magnifying glass, yet, father. Kangaroo. How did he get kangaroo in there? Kangaroos are indigenous to Australia. How did he get kangaroos in there? Did he walk to Australia and take back the kangaroos? It's strange. And this 500-foot boat. And him destroyed the whole earth. With all these people who don't have nothing to do with nothing. More than say them, some of them are farmers, some of them are animal. I mean, all these pregnant women, these little babies, you just destroy the whole earth because you say man mind get wicked and vain. So you got to start over. This is omnipotent, omnipresent, omniscient. We're supposed to know when you create something, say it's going to get weird. Just like when a man create a computer, I know, say, after a while, certain things are going to broke down the night. So you make parts to make more money off of you. We buy back the past them. So you know, really, that's where the computer itself, but that's where the things them in the computer. God, who is omnipotent, omniscient, make a whole world and make so much people upon the earth, and then take 8 people, put in an ark with 2 of every animal in it, and then wipe out the whole place with some flood rasta. And then when them come out of the ark, them get worse. So him never know, say, after them this, that means that when this. It's genocide, you know, because after them destroy the whole of the people, them and then come back now. You're going to tell me, they never know, so they get wickeder, and them get wickeder. And after 6,000 years, them get worse and worse and worse, you know, till they have to come with all them son and kill him own son. What kind of father that? Him kill him own son, and him kill him own son 2,000 years ago, and the world get worse. Man, like Al Bush about the place, and things just get terrible. It's weird. And you know, so as them come out of the ark, so you know where them do? Take the animal, the man offer them a sacrifice. After you save the animal, them in the heart. As you come out, you know, you say you go plant some food. You just take the animal, them because God said, at Genesis 8, me talk about, no, you know, Genesis 8 tell you, say, and Noah offer up the animal, them, as a sacrifice unto the Lord. And you ever know, they say, the man, them of God, you know, the Bible always get drunk. Oh, that. Appear drunk in people, God, love. Yeah, because Noah get drunk and lay down naked, so and him younger son come. I don't know when younger son do, because nobody from her can tell me, say, this all-powerful God curse a generation of people because the younger son just seem father nakedness. That's something else the younger son do. There's no way, and say, and him just do upon him father, him father's lay down the junk, you know. You tell me, say, no, a man lay down drunk. My father lay down drunk. And to me, going to go see my father naked. God just cursed the whole of my generation, them rasta. And black people, they attack them, come from Ham. What kind of fool story that? Come from which Ham? Ham is one of the sons of Noah. Ham, Shem, and Japheth. Yes, some black people say, we are from the tribe of Ham. I don't come from the tribe of Ham. Then which part of black, then where Noah come from? If Ham was black people, Japheth was the white people them, and Shem was the Asiatic people them. So Noah was what? No, where race Noah come from? Because Noah was before the three of them. We don't ever think out the story, you know. So them have this man now, I'm coming and seeing father nakedness. And the other son them coming and say, Lord God, where is you do? And them take one blanket and cover them father back way and walk out back way. And God looked upon Ham and cursed, not Ham, you know, him cursed him son, Canaan, and said, cursed be Canaan. So there is a distinct one son named Canaan now, that everybody know a fight for Canaan land, which is now what them call Palestine, and the Israeli them go in there and a fight for it. It's not none of them land, you know. It's not none of them land according to them book. It's Canaan land. Where the Canaanites them there? Where are the Canaanites today? Because a guy named, an Iraqi guy named Abraham, coming out of Iraq, and at those days it wasn't called Iraq, it was called Mesopotamia, and him come from the Ur of the Chaldees. He married to his sister named Sarah, and his sister couldn't get pregnant, and him said, the sister said, all right, go into the maid. What a beautiful woman that. Wow. She can't get pregnant. She said, God say, have sex with the maid. Lord God, I want to be that woman there. And she got have him go have sex with the maid. And when the maid get pregnant, the half-sister get pregnant too. And she realized, say, if she make the maid stay in there with the son, is the son going to inherit Abraham's inheritance? Because that is how them do them things. The elder son must inherit. So she chased son going to inherit Abraham's inheritance. Because that is how them do them things. The elder son must inherit. So she chased out the son out of the house and the mother and stay in there. And she have a son named Isaac. And the other son named Ishmael. And according to them, Ishmael is the father of the Arabs. And Isaac is the father of Israel. Because Isaac have two sons, Esau and Jacob. And we know the trickery we're going with Jacob and him friend them. And we accept these stories, you know. Because it's pure trickery. I go down the line, you know. All of the story them have a trickery in there. Where them say, it's God initiate the trickery. All of them. Never read any Lot. No, that is the weirdest one of them. Lot have two daughters in him house. And two men come a Lot house where them say them is angel. And the man them have the place where I'm living and name Sodom and Gomorrah. Well, people call Sodom more than him call Gomorrah. I don't know why. I don't know if the Sodomites them do have sex with man different from the Gomorrahites them. But God never make no differentiation. Look, I wipe out the whole of them. God is a homophobic God. You talk about Sizzler and keep it like that. God, homophobic God. I mean, you know that the gay people, they're ball out about it, you know. Imagine Lot having two daughters, them not out, and the two men, them not out, and the man, them upside them come and say, bring the man, them out here. Make do what you want do with them. And Lot look upon the man, them and say, look here, see me two daughters, them, yeah? Take them instead. Man, I'm saying, where you take me for heterosexual? I'm saying, bring the man them out here. What are you talking about? Bring the man them out here. And the man them in there, so you know. It now go work out, you know. So you are going to take your family and left this place, you know. Because we're going to destroy this place, you know. We'll call Bush. We mash up the city here. Totally devastate the city. With Jude and all them today. We're going to mash up the city. So take your family and move. No. Imagine them come out of the city. As I'm so say, the woman thing is really a problem in that story there, you know, because you know woman still, she have a certain compassion in her. More than likely, she will listen to all of the balling we are going in a Sodom there with all the brimstone and fire drop on the man there. And she couldn't take it. She could turn around. And she turned a pillar of salt. What kind of story that? The woman turned a pillar of salt. God make the woman turn a pillar of salt because he said the woman disobeyed. And God wipe out a city of homosexuals because I don't know. And Lot go in a cave with him two daughter them. And no, say only power never hear that story I hear today, but it's in the Bible. Lot go in a cave with him two daughter them. And the Lot get drunk again. Pure drunk, you know. And why Lot lay down the drunk, you know? Him elder daughter. Come inside and say, And she just run going to the younger sister and say, where you are? So me just going to the cave there a while ago and I say, daddy naked, you know, me I tell you, say, trust me, you think the man I'm a Sodom I go out with nothing? A fat daddy, you are, see? That's why I know, so mama did love him, so you know, that's why she told her pillar of salt. And you know the daughter though? The daughter going to her father and get pregnant. And when she get pregnant, she go to the younger sister and say, look here, see ya, daddy's son, listen up. Go in, go get your own. And the next younger sister go into her father and get pregnant too. That is incest, you know. That is incest in any language, in any culture. That is incest. But nothing never happened to neither the two daughters them nor Lot when them do that. Yet still, God wipe out a whole city of man who them claim says homosexual. And then now them come tell me about Jamaican people homophobic. You ever hear any artist wipe out any city? Or even three people or any family because they're homosexual. Most of the homosexual people that are Jamaica is them love or kill them. It's not the guy who just eat. Everybody, watch a man. Everybody, what me know, including myself, know a homosexual. And if you don't know a homosexual, you have to check yourself. You know, seriously. So nobody's in Jamaica. See, say a homosexual, I kill him. No, no, go so. I told them why you believe. I told them why you believe. But this, a whole city. Trust me, man. Me go a Sodom already. I mean, the physical Sodom and Gomorrah. Not even bush there. The place just blank, like a desert. Not grow there. Me don't know it's white. Maybe the car them said this so is the lowest sea, at bottom of sea level. But people say, if you go and ask the people in Israel, them tell you, say, it's because of Sodom get destroyed. Why not grow there? But then, when me I look on the whole of the desert, not good at the desert, either that side of that. So, it's a story that by itself. But you look on the whole thing and you say, but wait, this man sleep with him two sisters, two daughters, them, and nothing happened to him. They have a next man named Samson. A next drunkard again, you know. Samson supposed to be the strongest man on earth. Really, I don't know how he get to be the strongest man on earth. But me know, say, he's a drunkard. He's a dreadlocks, a very stupid dreadlocks. Him deserve him locks cut off. Yes. And for those of you who's Rasta inside here who drink alcohol, you deserve your locks cut off. Because a man supposed to be this man of God, this judge of Israel. A woman has come. Well, sister didn't read the poem about. Well, sister didn't come here to come read a poem. Everybody did that cheer, man. Eh? No, I see the man she name. Yeah, where the poem where she read name? Where's the man? Is she gone? Yeah, something like that, yeah. Mother like she inspire me, man. Trust me, we're up to inspiration right now. So if you want to wait till the show, don't. But we are telling you. Me need some inspiration. She gone? No, trust me, when she read the poem a while ago, I was totally inspired. And I was so feeling to be inspired more. But the man sit down there. And this woman come to him and said, rub up all the locks and rub up all the beard and all the things. And I said, tell me something, where you get your strength from? And the day I tell her, I said, a foolish shit, you know. And she said, hey, yeah. I said, yeah, if you cut off the wing of, if you cut off the wing of the bird can't fly from two, from one wing. And the lion without the mane, all sorts of things he might try to tell her. And she just say, yes, sonny, darling, yeah, man, all right. So tell me some, where's strength really there? And she just started to give him some Jerry and never rum. And sometimes I have some Baba Roots joke, you too. And I rub all him face to her, and then I pick all him toenail and all him, and then he start to get horny. And she just start to tell her and say, yeah, if you cut out the mane of the lion, you know, strength gone. If you pluck the feather, she just look at them locks and say, oh, I said, God. You see, when them get drunk and done, though, she just cut off the locks. And them just go blind him. Yes. He's another drunken man that again, you know. I mean, God loved drunken people so much that Jesus, they are waiting, you know. And them not have no wine there, you know. And God said, bring some water. I told it now, white. It's a terrible thing, this white thing, you know. One would believe that you need to drink wine to have that spirit of God. But it's pure drunken people. And most of the drunken people, them in the story, them get away. Check it. You ever hear a drunken man dead because of where my drink in the Bible? No, it's like him get elevated more. And the woman them go down more. Yes, the woman them get sink more in these stories. And then them woman them go down more. Yes, the woman them get sink more in these stories. And then them have a thing named Mary. And you hear some people say, oh, please don't make him talk about Mary. Yeah, we're going to talk about Mary. We're going to talk about Mary because we're not sacred about none of them. No. If a woman inside her can tell me, say, she never have no sex, and she have a picnic inside her soul, trust me, me no better go back to Jamaica. Yeah, because I'm going to have to examine everything about her. Why is it that we actually believe? Say, there's a woman named Mary that brought forth a child and she never have no sex. Can you imagine you in a city and a woman get pregnant in a city and she married and then she tell you, say, it's not the father, it's not my husband picnic. Which man inside I would have believed her? Which woman inside I would have believed her? But it said, look here now. Easy lady, watch your man. Me know say I go through all sort of tribulation and thing, you know, but it's Gabriel do it. And that the Bible say, Gabriel the angel. First of all, him go to the man, you know, and say, look here, your wife, I will get pregnant, you know, but don't feel away here, yeah, Bridget. And him go to Elizabeth. That I say, Elizabeth, watch out. Two child of a barn, you know. Because you know, say one name John the Baptist, and one name Jesus. So hear what me I say now. You see the one with name Jesus, don't feel away. It's not the husband. The Lord sent me here to go out with that thing. And only just work with that thing there. Don't feel like such a commit adultery and all that thing there. She was 15 years old when she got pregnant, you know. All right. The Bible is really a strange little thing surrounding that, because most Christians believe that it's a virgin birth, bring Jesus. When you read what virgin mean in the Greek text, because really and truly the New Testament was first written in Greek, and a whole if the Old Testament was written in Greek, even though the majority was written in Hebrew. When them say virgin, it never mean a woman who never have sex. All it means is a young woman shall conceive and have a child. It never have no intention. There was no intention to make you believe that the woman who have Jesus never have no sex. Because it never says so. It never mean that in none of the language, they never mean that. The idea of a virgin birth come from Egypt with a story about a goddess, which is a mythology, named Isis, Horus, and Osiris. And for those of you who don't know about it, who don't have no time to tell you the story, go look in some documents, go by your computer, go find out about Isis, Horus, and Osiris. That is where the idea of the virgin birth come from. Because them have God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. How is it that woman turn a ghost? Shouldn't it be God the Father, God the Child, and God the Mother? Families are disconnected when the mother not dead. And if you have in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, show you don't have respect for the woman. You don't have respect for the woman. If me was a woman, me not read the Bible, you know? No, because pure disrespect. Imagine a woman ever bring the savior of mankind in the earth, and she never have sex yet. And sex is the watch your man. Oh, a man tell me he say must be like Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, I can't live like Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ not born with no sin. He's a big sin. He's sin in squared. So me can't live like Jesus. And nobody has so can tell me say them not have the something with Christian called sin in them. Everyone away have sin. Jesus Christ not have no sin. So how you gonna live like a man then? Jesus Christ is like a freak of nature, you know. Nobody to come like him. Nobody no come like him. Yeah, nobody no come like him, you know. So it better give me a criminal who change him life. Like all Malcolm X. Malcolm X in a prison and do all sorts of things and he must come out and transform him life. And you say, well, here's a man who go through the things that a normal man go through and come out and overcome it. Jesus Christ not go through nothing because, I mean, years I'm like, hey, watch a man. You hear Jesus born, and then you hear say him get turned 12, and then after years he's a 30-year-old. 17 years I'm life, not in there, you know. You don't know when did that do, you know. If you go to Jamaica and they are tattoo and everything, you don't know nothing about him. And the man come, and his father kill him. He's a terrible father, that. Because after the father, You know, the first part of the book of the Bible, you have a man named Abraham, and he tell the man, say, take him son because sacrifice him son. And him do ever consult the mother. What happened to the mother? Oh, no, the mother wouldn't agree with that. And furthermore, you can imagine one of them brethren, you know, have a son, and go out to the middle of the square out there, so now, and say, why you want to see God tell me if you sacrifice my son, you know? People that call attempted murder. Nobody not charge God for attempted murder. Or Abraham. Or even consult with the mother. I say, tell me something, mama. You agree with your son being sacrificed to the Lord? Me, I bet you any money. Say the mother, nah, agree with that. Watch out. Me not be this way. You want to say you smoke too much ganja. That's why you think, say, man, I tell you to kill your son. You nah, come in and come kill my picnic. And then we're done 2,000 years after. It never worked with the lamb, the son over there. So them just catch a little lamb and kill the lamb and burn it and offer it up to the Lord. So then 2,000 years after now, them bring a man named Jesus Christ, the son of the same God. Where did I offer up the sacrifice them from down there? So him come up here so now and get him son, him only son, put him upon a cross. And you have black people that walk with cross around them neck. Suppose them they put Jesus on an electric chair. Will you put an electric chair on your neck? Why black people are walking around with cross? Them not used to the cross is an emblem of suffering and shame. That is how the Romans used to kill criminals. Them put them up on cross. We should not walk around with cross around the neck. It's an emblem of even the gospel tune say on the old ragged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. Suppose them did hang him with a rope. You'd have put a little rope around your neck and wear it as some suffering and shame. Why you walk with the suffering and shame? We have slavery there for shame already, you know. Nobody now walk with a little sheep around him neck. Maybe we should have walked with a little sheep around him neck because some of the sheep them did have names like Jesus. SS Jesus of Rubeck by John Hawkins. John Hawkins' sheep did name SS Jesus of Rubeck. One the name of John the Baptist. And meanwhile, them have a slave underneath. Them was worshiping God from the top. And it's a slave. It's a man who owns a slave ship, sing and write the song about amazing grace that saved a rich like me. And you have black people that sing that. Amazing grace that saved a rich like me. Rich like which me. And now them are singing, them don't get saved. You know, because like a hurricane come and wash their house. And they never talk about them get saved. See where? Man can't trade up bend down in the water yet how you're saved. I'm going to talk about, yes, him baptized in the name of the Holy Ghost. What the hell? You know, in a Jamaica, a person, them used to go in a river and baptize people. And this youth, him old youth down in the water, if he baptize youth, and the old youth dry him down in and drown, you know. The preacher may attack. Because I'm ready in the name of the Father, whoop, I'm lonely. And all of them whoop, and then I want to whoop and drive him down in the water to ride and I drown him. A true story, I tell you, it's so like joke. The pastor get drowned. Can you imagine? People actually believe that if them dip in the water, them sins get washed away. What kind of madness is that? Oh, black people get caught in that. We don't even know if you love one another. You, watch your man. If you want to know where God, they just look beside you, man. Especially if a woman is beside you. Because you're not going to find God in a church. A long time God left the church, you know. You just sit down there. And the best place to meditate is up on your toilet bowl. Yeah, man. Already constipated. You sit down on your toilet bowl, man. Things just come to you, man. Come to you. God not in a church. No man, it's fear. It's fear them have within a man. I say the fear of God is the beginning of knowledge. But them say, fear, love casts away fear. If you love God, you cannot fear him. Because if you fear God, you cannot love him. Because love is void of fear. And what religion give you is fear. I believe. Knowledge is power. When you have knowledge, you don't have to believe nothing. Knowledge cast away mystery power. When you have knowledge, you don't have to believe nothing. Knowledge cast away mysteries. Fear is developed through mystifying things. And when you mystify something, Like a man tell you, say, boy, I have bush attack to man. What the hell that is all about? Bush attack to man. You have all Rasta now and get so involved in that with a ganja tree. A foolishness. Whether it's a ganja tree or a mango tree or a bird tree, bush can attack. It's just crazy because the more you get into the religion thing, you know, it's the more madness you get, you know. It's a kind of madness thing, you know. Yeah, because even Rasta, when you talk to all the Rasta, them say, they ain't no say. The tree that Moses did attack was a herb tree. Yeah, I say, what the rest is this? Which herb tree? What are you talking about? Which tree attack? You know it anyway in the world. And the president said, which tree attack the people? I go to the man, go up to the mountain and I meditate. Just like when I said, go in and I tithe and I sit down. Can't no church never the boat. I'm going to go up to the mountain and sit down. I meditate and I think about how I'm going to get these little idiot people out of the craziness where them have. Because them come out of Egypt and them have the residues of Egypt and them. And I say, well, I'm going to get them out of this, you know. So him create some little things, manipulate them, like a little box. Him create a little box and say, look, anyway, the box, they are God represented, you know, them call it the Ark of the Covenant. It don't have nothing to do with nothing more than his man that create these things. You hear a man talk about, say, all right, you so, watch your man. Moses, Mr. Udon, you know, Mr. Udon, trust me, Mr. Ube could go up. Moses, in the Bible, it said Moses' stammer. Moses was a stammer man, so Aaron, his brother, have to talk for him. Moses. And God got, Moses got in the mountain and God said, watch out, go down in Egypt, go tell Pharaoh to let me go my people them. And Moses, I said, me if you go talk to Moses, me if you go talk to Pharaoh, you mad? He said, look here, all right, you are. Throw down your rod upon the ground. When he threw down his rod upon the ground, he turned, sneered. He said, I take it up back. And Moses said, well, no, I'm not taking it up. He said, all right, take it up, man. And him take it up, boof, and he turn back around. God said, all right, go down there. Go do the same thing what you just do a while ago. Remember, I said, Moses stammer, you know. The Bible said, Moses stammer, you know. So I hear and I go talk to him, you know. You see, when Moses reached down there, and Moses attacked without the stammer, you know. And I tell Pharaoh, I say, in the name of Yahweh, God said, let my people go. And Pharaoh looked upon him and I said, what are you dealing with? And Moses goes up, blue man, throw down him snake. Throw down him rather than turn snake. Fear I just laugh and I go so click and click him man and call about 10 men outside and get them running and go bloom. Just when Moses said that Moses fright because Moses feet on go feel God could have turned rather than a snake. If never know the Egyptian could have turned rather than a snake too. But why make the story look like it's an Israel story is that Moses' snake eat up the other snake then. And Moses left and never let Pharaoh never let go of the people then. And God, Moses go back up to the mountain, you know. I said, boy, me I tell you the truth, you know, God. You tell me if you throw down my rod and it will make the people them go and nothing happen, you know. God say, all right, go down there. Go tell the people there. Tell Pharaoh to let my people go. You see, meanwhile, Pharaoh go down there. Sorry, meanwhile, Moses go down there. God just call Pharaoh and just say, watch out, don't let them go. It's a game God has played, though. And when Moses reached down there now, and God, him say, all right, you see, if you don't let go my people them, we are going to make the water, all of the water them in Egypt turn blood. And when all of the water them turned blood, Moses said, are you must let go my people them now? And Pharaoh said, all right, I'm going to let go the people them. And yes, when the river turned back, Pharaoh said, how are you talking about? I'm not let go nobody, Rasta. And Moses go back up on the mountain and said, God, what are you dealing with? You played me now. And no, boss, if you go to Egypt, you come back up yesterday, Rasta. What are you telling me? Every time you said, me go down, that's the man, I'm going to let go the man, and I'm not let them go. God said, all right, go down there again, and I'm let them go. You see me, I'm go down there. Boom, God just take up him digital cell phone. He said, bruh, digital cell now work on yourself, and line work on yourself. Boom. Call Pharaoh, I said, Pharaoh, watch out, I'm going to come back here. I play them, don't let them go. And about 10 times, him go down to God, go down to Pharaoh, you know. And God not let him go, you know. And this time now, I play, I'm going to lick them now till all of the son them, the firstborn son them, in Egypt, I go dead now. Even the Israelites son them was firstborn and got dead. But here God said, no, God said, you know, you're going to walk around the place and mark upon the Israelites them door. All of the Israelites them was firstborn. That when Bush come through, he kill out the picnic them. Him don't kill the Israelites, him just kill pure Iraqi. All right. So, God now, according to the story, make all of the firstborn them dead. This is not a genocide again, you know. God, the compassionate, the ever-loving God wipe out all of the firstborn children of Egypt. And Pharaoh said, all right, we can't take this rasta, we don't go on. Moses stand up on a mountain in front of 1 million people without any microphone and nothing. And I talk to 1 million people, and the 1 million people, them hear him, they see. What kind of story that? The 1 million people, them hear when they talk, you know. Take all your belongings and things and come, let us leave Egypt. God has delivered us this day. The day of the Passover now will take place, where them now call Easter. We should not have nothing to do with nothing, you know. Easter is a European thing, you know. All right. So Moses is going to carry the people, them now, and walk, now, and Pharaoh, ears of them gone now, you know, and they're going to get up all them soldiers, them now, you know. They're going to fight back. When the Israelites, them walk, them walk up on the sea. People, them say, wait, how are we going to cry? The madness is now. Oh, hey, Moses, how are you dealing with it? Watch your man, how are you dealing with it? Oh, you have to bring Obama up here and kill off your blood, bad skirt. They say, oh, you bring this man, bring him come here so we can't cry. The Bible say that Moses hold out the man so, and the sea part so, and the old people them, with all of them cow and them goat and all them things, a walk across this water, and the water over that side there, and the water over that side there, and it now come down for the land. No, trust me, man. When we imagine that story there, we are things say the road between the water them, a straight road, you know. Sea, you know, stay so, you know. The further you're going at the sea, and the more it go down so. So if you was to take out the water out, it would come like it's a mountainside, you know. Trust me, man. When you watch all movie, man, the Ten Commandments, you see the Israelites walk across this road there like it never paved, but it have gravel. I never walk past it. Are you not thinking of your mind, say, no go so, you know. No water, mass and water. Now got there a place. We just straight when the water separates itself. Because water is beach and it'll go down so. So the land will go down so. So more than like you have to go and climb down the further you reach down there, so you know. But we take the story. We take the story. We don't question them story there. Them story there in our consciousness for years. And the more it gets repeated, is the more we accept it and don't question it. This poem shall speak of the wretched sea that worships to these shores, of mothers crying for their young swallowed up by the sea. This poem shall say nothing new. This poem shall speak of time, time unlimited, time undefined. This poem shall call names, names like Lumumba, Kenyatta, Hannibal, Akhenaten, Malcolm, Garvey, Haile Selassie. This poem is vexed about apartheid, racism, fascism, the Ku Klux Klan, riots in Brixton, Atlanta, Jim Jones. This poem is revolting against first world, second world, third world, division, man-made decision. This poem is like all the rest. This poem will not be amongst great literary works, will not be recited by poetry enthusiasts. It will not be quoted by politicians nor men of religion. This poem is knives, bombs, guns, blood, fire, blazing for freedom. Yes, this poem is a drum, a shanty, ma ma, Igbo, Yoruba, Nyabingi warriors, Yohuru Yohuru, Yohuru Namibia, Yohuru Sweto, Yohuru Africa. This poem will not change things. This poem need to be changed. This poem is a rebirth of a people, arising, awakening, understanding. This poem speak, is speaking, have spoken. This poem shall continue even when poets have stopped writing. This poem shall survive you, me, it shall linger in history, in your mind, in time, forever. This poem is time, only time will tell. This poem is still not written. This poem has no poet. This poem is just a part of the story. His story, her story, our story. The story is still untold. This poem is now ringing, talking, irritating, making you want to stop it. But this poem will not stop. This poem is long, cannot be short. This poem cannot be tamed. Cannot be blamed. The story is still not told about this poem. This poem is old, new. This poem was copied from the Bible, your prayer book, Playboy magazines, the New York Times, Reader's Digest, the CIA files, the KGB files. This poem is no secret. This poem shall be called boring, stupid, senseless. This poem is watching you trying to make sense from this poem. This poem is messing up your brains, making you want to stop listening to this poem. But you shall not stop listening to this poem. You need to know what will be said next in this poem. This poem shall disappoint you because this poem is to be continued in your mind, in your mind, in your mind.